Today is the last day, and after some time we will depart. It appears that we departed from each other, but really speaking, we are trying to come together as one. No one departs, no one leaves. It is just apparent thing that we think that we are departing. When Baba would be holding Sahvas program, so last day, of course, it was very difficult for the people to leave. There was one person, Hira Lal. You must be knowing. He is still there. So in 1958, everyone left and Hira Lal did not leave. Baba would be not able to walk, but he went to him to the Pendal and he asked him, why don't you go? And he says, when I go there, I forget you, but when I am here, there is nothing to remember, but the remembrance is so natural that I enjoy that natural company of you. I don't want to go. And Baba said, I will call you. I give you promise. I will call you. And then you will be here permanently. So with great difficulty, of course, he left. And Baba did call him after dropping the body. So Hira Lal, of course, since then, he is there at Mehrabad. He appears like mad. But he is not mad. He just goes on singing. He does samadhi duty. And of course, he is very old now. But still, he does not leave Mehrabad. His wife was there. But when he was there, he would say that I have no relation with anyone. He would be that Mehar Dham was constructed, he would go and sleep there. And he appears like mad. People would think that he is really mad, but he is really, what he is, of course, nobody knows. So much love he had. This song, which Ravi just saying, it was saying in 1953 at Tadipalli Gudam that Dr. Dhanpati Rao, who was the head of the group, he is head of whole Andhra. It was he, because of him, people came to know about Meher Baba. And he had only Baba's darshan in 1944 when Baba went to Madras. He took Baba's darshan and he belonged to Baba 100%, very sincere, very honest. So this song, it was sung by the name. No, don't. Bhaskar Raju. He does not know this. I was testing your memory. But it is not his mistake. Of course, he was not born at that time. So, Bhaskar Raju, and this song was written by his brother. And Bhaskar Raju sang this song, and Baba liked it very much. He liked it very much, and it was his birthday. Baba's birthday, it was celebrated in Tadipalli Gudam, I think in 1954. And then, of course, this song all over India in different places. Of course, they don't know Telugu, but most of the words are Sanskrit word. Sanskrit words, so they know. So afterwards, then of course Baba, two visits to Baba, where Baba paid two visits to Andhra. And Andhra, if you go, you will feel so happy, so happy. Only one person knows. And do you know who is that? Infinite Griss. He is respected there like anything. Big procession comes to receive him. He is not ordinary person. And he has given promise me too that he would not marry again. Yes. So this afterwards, today I have to tell you about new life. What is new life? What is the end of new life? The end of new life is annihilation of mind. Mano nash. When your mind is annihilated, then you are one with God. And the purpose of life is, then it is complete. Why we have come in creation? Everyone is going towards that, and no one knows. Only one person, two persons are there. One is Jivan Mukta, he knows. And another is outside sitting there, Kutube Alam. So, he knows. Kutube Alam, they want to see your face. Yeah. And of course, you did not show your face. Yes. What do you are?
What am I?
Yes.
Those who know don't say, and those who say don't know.
No, but yes. That is all right. This is intellectual answer. But who are you?
Those who know who I am.
Jivan Mukta. But they want to see your face.
Oh, you want me to stand up?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Jivan Mukta and Kutube Alam. So when, for that purpose, in order to become Jivan Mukta, you have to pass through new life. That is the life. Of the aim of life is to annihilate your mind. This mind is limited, and because of this limited mind, we always remain limited. but one day you have to analyze whether you want it or you don't want it. And when that stage, even when you one enters into this subtle world, this gross consciousness, it goes away. Then of course you just see that what is this? What is this world? Nothing. So he is not, as soon as you go to subtle world, of course there is nothing gross. Gross thing means any worldly happiness, the whole worldly happiness, if put together, it is just nothing. Just nothing. So now this Jivan Mukta, he has not only achieved God consciousness, but also he has achieved the what you call that creation consciousness. So, and because he has the creation consciousness, because he has the creation consciousness, so he can know what you are thinking, there is that, everything. That he is connected with the creation for his work. And work means just to make one like himself. Jivan Mukta. Of course, in his company, those who live or those who go, they are benefited. But actually his work is to make one like himself. There is that Kutub-e-Alam. That Kutub-e-Alam also after having this God realization, then again he comes down to creation consciousness. Baba has once described, when Baba was with Upasani Maharaj in Sakori for 6 months continuously, at that time the pain he would put up with, that it was such pain that coming down from that highest state to the state of creation, so sometimes there was one pond, and Baba would put his head in the pond. In the pond he would remain there. And of course when he was getting this creation consciousness, he would just hit his head against the stone. In Baba's room there in Pune, where Baba was living, if you go that, the stone is there. But nowadays people went and they started taking a little bit of stone from there, means cutting. So now they have packed it, but you can see the stone. So he would hit his head against that, the pain, and he would get relief. When he would, just blood would be out, and then when he would come out, he would just dry the blood and come out as if nothing, that but the cloth would be there, and the mother would see, and mother would think that whether he has become mad or what. So this life in creation consciousness, when one gets God realization, one with God, but he thinks everyone is one. So everyone, not as everyone, but one. But when one gets creation consciousness, just like Jivan Mukta and that Kutub-e-Alam, so they know the world, creation. Though they are always above this world, but for work they have to do this. So new life Baba started. I will not go into detail, otherwise up to 6 o'clock also I will not be able to complete it. But in order to give that idea that this age what Baba has given, so new life when Baba started, nothing was kept in his name. Nothing. 700 acres of land at Mehrabad disposed of at the rate of 10 rupees, 15 rupees per acre. Baba says within 15 days dispose it off, and Baba would come in the morning, up to evening he would be just telling the Mandi members of the instruction he would give, what you have to do and this, and then he would go back to Mehrazad, and then poor Pendu and Ramju, they would do this transaction. They would call the people from Arangaon, and whatever they can give, they would just give. And but still there were some acres of land not sold out, but Baba said leave it. And other people, of course, they had the position. So nothing in his name, and till he dropped his body, nothing in his name. In 1959, Baba, of course, this trust was created. And trust was created in 1959, but it was not working. Not working because donation up to 1,000 rupees. Not more than that. So donation if comes, so 1,000 rupees, and people did not know that the trust was created. But in 1969, when Baba dropped his body, at that time, of course, the Westerners had to come, Easterners had to come, and Baba had chalked out everything, 69 darshan program, one day visit to Mehrabad. And that whole program, it was chalked out during Baba's physical presence, and 69 darshan program, and Baba would suffer and suffer, and still we would think that Baba had to attend this program. So it is not possible for Baba to drop the body. He was suffering terribly. But never anyone of the Maldi thought that he would drop the body. But before that, of course, he arranged everything. Now, Westerners in summer, the program very hot, and there was no place. No place when they go for go to Baba's Samadhi. So then how to stand there? So for that purpose, of course, some shade should be made there. No money. So we took loan from someone to construct that building, which is called Sabha Mandap. So it was taken loan and it was constructed. That Lord of the universe, nothing left. When he dropped his body, nothing, he did not leave anything. Just like this, and program was arranged. But it went on very well. Went on very well. And in his absence, and no one felt that he was absent. His chair, it was there, they would just feel that Baba is there. So this new life, the end of new life means to become one with God. Now Baba passed through four phases. First phase was the phase of begging. Second phase is meditation. Third place, gypsy life, that is life of hopelessness and helplessness. And the fourth phase, labor phase. So first phase, begging, for that also Baba gave training. Training not when he started new life on 16th October, he went to Belgaum. One place is called Belgaum in Maharashtra, and he was there and he was giving training for the begging. How you should beg. When you are begging, you are beggars, so you cannot demand anything and you cannot say anything. You just go. If anyone gives, of course it is all right. If he does not give, they would say that you are young and why don't you work? Dr. Duncan was in new life. So Dr. Duncan, India got independence in 1947. And Dr. Duncan puts on robe and goes for begging. This Britisher, how he comes, there must be some trick. They would just close the door. Poor Duncan, of course, and Dr. Nilu, both were two persons in a group for begging. So no one would get anything. Very seldom. But when Baba would go, Baba would bring. And people would give him. And whatever they would give, just he would put. In this bag he had put, or something which is cooked food. So then he has one bowl, so he would keep, and he would bring. So this life, begging, then when he went to Banaras, begging started there, and also after that Baba went to Sarnath, the place of Buddha. And place of Buddha, so Baba had been there many times he visited that place, Sarnath. So this time again he went to Sarnath, and it was winter, very, very cold. Very cold, and everyone had to get up and take bath at 4 o'clock with cold water. And then sit outside to meditate. To meditate, of course, they would sit outside and meditate. So it went on, and then afterwards Baba came down to Banaras walking, and then Baba, everyone has watch and also warm clothes. Baba said, now we will be going to Hyderabad, Haridwar, begging and leading that gypsy life. So living under the tree and begging for the food. But what about the animals? Baba had two cows, they are given to Baba in gift. So two cows, one horse, white horse, then of course camels, two camels, camel cart, bullocks for the cart, so that their luggage should be put there. And they were just going to Haridwar, and they people would think that there was Kumbh Mela in Haridwar. Kumbh Mela, it comes after 12 years. In each place, four places are there. So millions of people go there at that time. So for that, people also go walking. So Baba was walking, begging, and living under the tree. And then afterwards, tree, and then they would eat whatever they would bring. So this went on, and then Haridwar. From Haridwar, Baba went along with Ladies Mandi to Dehradun. Because near Dehradun, there was one place which was secured. It was called Majri Mafi. And Kumar, Satrughn Kumar, Amrit's father, his story is very, really, that story, that what he was and what he became. So he was an independent political leader, and he was sent to jail. Now when he was sent to jail, there were other political leaders there. So every evening, of course, they would come together and pray to God. And this one, Kumar, would say, "These people, they are mad. Where is God?" He was communist. "Where is God? They just blind faith, and they do it our own strength. We must fight with the Britishers with our own strength. What they are doing?" And then he would just tell the political leaders different things, that just have the revolt here. And the jailer came to know, so he was given rigorous punishment. And what was the rigorous punishment? In the morning he should go and just sit on the roof of the jail. And roof, it was summer, and tin sheet. He would be burnt. He would be burnt. So he was just thinking, what to do now? What to do? How to go out of this? So he thinks that these people, of course, pray to God. I would also pray, but my prayer would be conditional prayer, that if I would be released from this jail, then I would follow him. Conditional prayer. So at 4 o'clock, he got down and took bath. But prayer, how to pray? That too he did not know. So he said, Mr. God, if you release me by morning tomorrow, 8 o'clock, then I will follow you. I will follow you wholeheartedly. Whatever you say, I will do. And what happens? Next day, jailer comes at 8 o'clock in his room, and he says, "Now you are released, just sign here." There is Mr. God. There is Mr. God. Now he believes that there is Mr. God, but we have to find. Let us go. So he came out of the prison, and then of course he went to his home, and there he was political leader. So his living means that table, desk and chair, armchair, and he would read newspaper, cigar and coffee, everything. He would just drink coffee and read newspaper. And one day two persons came there, and then what happened? They said that, can you help us to find some land here? Find land? Why? They said that our party is coming for Kumbh Mela, and they would stay here for some days. So we would have the cottages for ladies Mandli and men Mandli. So they would not say Mandli, they would say that ladies are there and men are there. So we have some cottages because they will be living here for some days. When do you want? They said, as soon as possible, and if it is secured in 1 week, we will be very happy. 1 week? Today I give you. So they said that all right, just show the land. So he showed, and he said that all right, we will let you know. So they sent to, at that time Baba was telling about new life. Instructions were given, and at the time that came, the telegram came, and of course Baba approved that land, and it was purchased, and cottages, he himself took the charge up to construct cottages there, and one well for water. So then that work he was doing. But then what happens? Baba sent Keko Bath there. He was very old, new life. So he was in Delhi. Baba had sent him in Delhi, you be there. But then when one cottage was ready, he was sent there. So he would always keep his door closed, and he would remember God's name 100,000 times. He would start from the morning at 9 o'clock. He would stop. Means he would complete. And then of course Keko Bath, he was the only one in Mandli. Tea and breakfast means 6 o'clock in the morning. It should not be 6:05. No, 6 o'clock. Lunch at 11, and the dinner at 6. Fixed time, not a minute here and there. No, he would not be able to bear it. So this Kumar took the charge of this, and he would take the breakfast in the morning, and his door would be closed. He would close the door at 6 o'clock, not keep it open, but when he would hear some sound, because that one Kumar would go, so 6 o'clock he would just open and close. And what happened? One day Kumar thinks about that, why this old man, what does he do whole day? Never comes out, what does he say, do there? So one day he just thought that I must try to see. So he was handing over, but looking this side, handing over the food to Kekobad, looking this side, and there was Baba's picture. As soon as he saw Baba's picture, he said, "This is Mr. God." Mr. God, of course, he has released from the jail, and now, yes, I have given that promise that whatever he wants to do with me, whatever he asks to do, I will do. So now, how to find out? And Kekobad would not talk, would not say anything. Nobody was allowed to talk about Baba. Up to 1952, people did not know that Meher Baba is there. No. He would go out for mastur, contacting the poor. Poor program, thousands would come, but he would be incognito, and nobody would know. Just like one person from businessman, he is very philanthropic. So, in this way, but his name would never be disclosed. They did not know who was he. He would bow down and Pendu would be ready. Ready for what? Money. And Baba would not touch money at that time when he would give to anyone. At that time he would touch the money. So, Pendu would give and Baba would give. There would be some. They would say, only this much? So Baba would give them more. And then after completing this work, then Baba said that three phases of new life we have been leading. But now the fourth phase, and in three phases nobody succeeded, not a single one. So these three phases I will do for you, and only one phase you do for me. And what is that new phase, the fourth phase? Labor phase. So labor phase, of course, Baba said, who wants to take? In labor phase there were three plans. Plan number one, plan number two, plan number three. Plan number three means they had to be with Baba and serve him, follow his orders. First plan, A, B, C. So in A, B, C, of course, it was just you can live anywhere, do anything, any business or job, whatever you want. You just do. And he had given the conditions. The conditions are there, 10 conditions. Follow the conditions. So this was first plan. Second plan is that those who are disabled, so they should choose that plan to serve the helpless, old persons, helpless persons. So this is second plan. And first plan, you go and then you have take any job or business or whatever you want to do, earn, but follow the conditions. And the third plan, of course, he continued for some time, and that plan also he abolished. Why? In order to show, in order to get God realization, in order to lead new life, his physical presence is not required. And that's why he sent the those Mandali members who were with Baba to Delhi to do the business of ghee. And ghee means butter. So butter, of course, they make ghee out of butter. And summer time, Delhi very hot and near the fire. They had to be there. And butter, there was one person who would bring butter from Lucknow, from Allahabad. So this went on. And then Baba said that these three phases of new life, I will lead for you. You lead only one phase, and that is labor phase. Now in labor phase, whatever business, if you want to do business, you do cultivation. If you want to do cultivation, you do. If you have any job, you do that job. But follow those conditions. So this is that it appears that how can one get God? How can we find God when we do job or just like Jeff? Of course, he is Jivan Mukta, but what he is doing? He is writing the script for the film. And goes, when I came there, so before that, of course, he was not free up to 5 o'clock. Of course, he would be in the studio. 5 o'clock in the morning, but that is also labor phase. It comes under labor phase. So he is also giving example, though I am Jivan Mukta, but I am doing this. And where is that air purifier? Water. Kutub-e Alam. And there is another person, do you know? Another one. Sham. You just call him Sam. But Sham. Sham means Krishna. Yes. You don't know? Today I am introducing him. He is Krishna. Yes, yes. Conditions, of course, 10 conditions I don't remember, but only thing, you can do anything, your job or this, but know well that you are doing for him. Whatever you be honest, be sincere, be loving. 10 conditions are there, I don't remember, but now I have written separate book. It you will find in Lord Meher. But also, I have written separately, New Life. It is not published, it will take time to publish it. When I die, it will be published. So, then this labor phase, it is very important. And know well that only one phase, labor phase, if you do, then three phases, the Beloved Himself will do for us. And what a burden He has taken upon Himself. But you will see that this new life would come in different form after His universal manifestation. After His universal manifestation, because the people will get the awakening. They will get the awakening and then they will start this new life in different form, because different plans are there. And I still feel that after, say, before he comes down again, again the same thing would happen. Some, just like the church and this and that, all this priest class may come. Though Baba has said that this of course you don't need anything, just remember me, follow new life. New life means labor phase. And then of course you are following me. And I will do three phases for you. I will lead three phases for you. Only one phase for you, you must do it. Honestly, sincerely. But this is the time. It is very, very difficult. People are corrupt, selfish, greedy, all sorts of wants. So very difficult. The time has come, but he will create that situation when people will get that awakening and they will do it rightly. Here, of course, this time if you do that, if you are honest, if you want to suffer, you will do. There is nothing. You will do, you will pass through. His help is there. But very difficult. Very difficult, and awakening is needed. And awakening, when awakening comes, then automatically will happen. But after 100 years, then of course when you call him, so he is present. If you don't call, he is not present after 100 years. During this period, whether you remember him or you don't remember him, he will remember you. And he will do everything for you. But after 100 years, no. If you remember him, he is there. Otherwise, he will not forget. So gradually, that the same thing, the priest class will come forward, and new life, labor phase. One will lead this phase, another will one go to another phase, like this. So it will happen. And why he has to come back again and again? This is the reason. Because afterwards, God is forgotten, and what is the world is remembered. Whatever in the world is there, and if you go to God, the priest, they are there. And whatever the priest says, yes, you do it. And then you think that you follow God. No one, God is not followed from here, intellect. God is through heart. So it is very, very difficult, but know well, you are all very fortunate, I should say, that how you have come to his contact. How he has come, you have come to his contact, you also don't know. You may know that, yes, you read this or you heard about him, and that's why you have come. But that is not the outer means, external thing. Baba's literature is there. Lot of literature now in internet you will find. So it is available to everyone. But whether everyone is coming, but the time will come. For this time he has said that whole world will recognize me. And it will happen. Then of course you have not to worry what you have to do. You will do. But everything should be put into deeds, thoughts and words. It is not that, oh, I know about Meher Baba, he is like this. Yes, you know. But it is in the heart. you act upon, put those words of truth into action. Otherwise, it is of no use. Only Ravi is trying. Right? You are trying. Good. Only one person is here, Ravi. And Ravi means, do you know? Ravi means sun. Yes. So he knows how to put those words. He will not. He can say that I am leading new life. He will say, do you beg for food? He said, oh, the beloved is doing for me. Do you meditate? He said, no, the beloved is doing for me. I don't worry. Gypsy life, life of hopelessness and helplessness. Do you lead that life? He is leading for me. So what do you do? I am just trying to have a good job, earn money, but honestly, lovingly for him, follow the conditions, 10 conditions, right? So you are trying. Very good. He will try, he has been trying, right? And that's why you sing Namo Meher Baba. 54. Baba says 60 years, it is said that in 60 years that you go on losing your memory. So now 60 years I have completed, so I will start losing my memory. So sometimes you help me for that. And one time that phase came, and Baba says, I don't know, please help me. He would come and he would sit in the Mandli hall, and we would look at him. He said, now I forget things. What you have to do, I was just telling, but I forgot. Please help me. And the more he would do, the more we would know that he knows. He knows. But he would just remain as if he does not know anything. He has forgotten. He has forgotten. And he would say, please help me. I don't know. So different phases of Baba. But one thing, he cannot forget us. Cannot forget the world. He cannot forget the sinners even. He cannot forget. Sinners, worst type of sinners. In 100 years, these sinners, they will, Baba has given one message that sinners are his liability, and saints are his assets. And what is his work? To change the liability into asset. To change the liability into asset, that is his work. So he goes on doing that. Never think that Baba is not physically present. He does not listen. How can he listen? Let the mind work, but you follow. Labor phase, very easy he has given, but it is most difficult phase. I tell you, it is easy, but most difficult, because in everything you should be honest. You should be honest. And of course, you go for job, any job, and you are late. So what excuse? So you prepare the excuse that I would tell this. That is not honesty. That is not honesty. One has to be very, very honest. Very honest, loving. Now you will say that why should I follow this man who is the administrator? Why should I follow? I do my work. And if he says anything, it is not that he is perfect or he knows God and he is doing for God, but you are doing for God. So when you are doing for God, if he gets upset, all right. That is your opportunity to keep patience. So should not that this man, what he can tell me, he can teach me, he does not know anything, know nothing, you know. Keep quiet. If he says anything, you did not come in time, or if you come, no, just see this. But don't go on just fighting with him. Never do so. So only thing, this will be your inner awakening. And you will become very, very strong. You will not remain weak, but to digest the things. Baba has said that if anger comes, what you should do? You just take your hands behind and keep your mouth shut. So long the anger is there, you should not say anything. When anger is not there, then of course you are free. If he blames you, so you are free to say, no, I have done this, I did not do that. So that is, but anger should not be there. That you know Prophet Muhammad, his first disciple Ali. So Prophet Muhammad had told him that when anger is at that time, fighting, of course, here and there, all over, even they stoned Prophet Muhammad, and he had to leave Makkah and went to Medina. So such was the situation. So still he said to Ali, when you are angry, then of course you should not touch anyone. Just keep quiet. So Ali knew that this is order of Prophet Muhammad. But one day, one enemy came and challenged him. And when he challenged him, Ali of course got very angry and knocked him down in no time. And he was sitting on his chest. And what happens? He remembers the word of the Prophet. He just left him and stood up. When he stood up, the enemy also stood up. And then he knew. So he started abusing him. Ali was quiet. Then he went spitting on him, kicking him. But still the anger was there. He did not say a word. He did not say a word. He was spitting on him, kicking him, but did not say. So whether he was coward, he was the brave. That is bravery. That you can control your anger. So he was doing all this. Still, of course, he did not say anything because he remembered the word of the Prophet. And that's why Baba says, just have your hand behind. If you are angry, don't say anything. Keep your mouth shut.
What do you do if you're driving the car and you can't put your hand behind?
When you are in the car, of course, there is no question of fight.
But
where?
You
No, no, but angry, you are angry with someone. Angry with someone, but that someone was not there. You can abuse him. There is nothing wrong. While sitting in the car you are going, so you just, you can in order to get out of the anger, you can just say anything to him. He will not listen.
But that is backbiting. But doesn't it come under backbiting?
Backbiting never do. Never do that. This is not backbiting. You are, if he comes and if he says that, did you abuse me? You say, yes, I did. But now, you are my friend. I did, and I made you friend. Something which is against your mind, of course, it causes anger. Whatever you want, if it is not like that, then you get angry. So anger, of course, just mind stuff, stuff of the mind. What? Conditions. They wanted, yes, read out. Take mic, yes. The conditions of new life, 10 conditions.
So first it says, Baba writes, although the new life has emerged from me, I am not at all bound by it. Plans 1, 2, and 3 of the new life, with their 4 phases of labor, begging, gypsy, and langoti life, will function as long as I am physically alive. But this new life is endless, and even after my physical death, will be kept alive by those who live the life of complete renunciation of falsehood, lies, hatred, anger, greed, and lust, and who to accomplish this do no lustful actions, do no harm to anyone, do not backbite, do not seek material possessions or power, who accept no homage, neither covet honor nor shun disgrace, and fear no one and nothing. By those who rely wholly and solely on God, and who love God purely for the sake of loving, who believe in the lovers of God and in the reality of manifestation, and yet do not expect any spiritual or material reward, who do not let go the hand of truth, and who, without being upset by calamities, bravely and wholeheartedly face all hardships with 100% cheerfulness and give no importance to caste, creed, and religious ceremonies. This new life will live by itself eternally, and even if there is no one to live it. The conditions for those who accept Plan 1A, B, and C and Plan 2. 1. First and foremost, you must take it as an absolute and unqualified certainty that you will not receive even the slightest spiritual or material benefit, or indeed any benefit whatsoever. On the contrary, you must be prepared for every kind of disappointment and adversity. You should not expect that Baba will have his nazar on you, or that he will perform miracles or use his spiritual key to protect or save you from illness, danger, imprisonment, death, or difficulties and disasters of any kind. 3. You will not touch women, except when necessary, your mother, wife, sister, and daughter, or professionally when you are doing a doctor's profession. 4. You will not enter politics. 5. You will not express anger by word or deed to anyone, whatever the provocation, and you will not criticize anyone unfairly, either to his face or behind his back. Although you may at times feel anger in your mind, you must never express it in word or deed. 6. You will tell no lies under any circumstances. 7. Neither Baba nor you will accept homage from anyone, nor will you deliberately create circumstances that might invite homage to Baba or to you. If, however, Without your having invited it, homage is given to Baba or to you. It must be repaid action for action to the giver. Number eight, it must be clearly understood that although the conditions are binding on you all, Baba himself is not bound by any order or condition and is absolutely free for all time. Number nine, the one and only thing, however, in which Baba not only is not free, but deliberately binds himself, is regarding the condition that you will not receive the slightest benefit of any kind whatsoever, and that you must be prepared for every kind of disappointment and adversity. It's real. It must, in addition, be absolutely clear that Baba will also never give any order that will absolve any of you of your individual responsibility before God for any consequences that may follow. You must take it as an absolute certainty that the responsibility before God for each and every consequence rests for all time wholly and solely with you and you alone, and that Baba will never give an order that will change or nullify this responsibility. Number 10, you will not commit any lustful action with anyone, male or female, young or old. Meher Baba.
This conditions why I did not tell you, because it is like atom bomb. So atom bomb, and I said that now you are in a good mood. You are just laughing and enjoying, and if I create any fear, so that is no good, so I avoided. But of course Baba wanted that I should not avoid, and that's why he reminded him to read out that. But only thing I will tell you, that atom bomb, Baba has said that my words are like atom bombs. And atom bombs, generally it is used by Baba's words are atom bomb, but nobody thinks that those words, they become atom bomb. Atom bomb are there, but it must be used. How it should be used? It should be put into action. And action, thoughts, and speech. Then of course that is atom bomb. Words of truth are always atom bomb, provided you are experiencing that, you have to put them into action. Otherwise you just talk about Baba's words, atom bomb. Now I hear from different people, what are you telling? Baba's words are atom bombs. Yes, atom bombs are there, but those atom bombs, if you just make bombs, so what is the use of that? They should be used. They should be used, then only of course you know the effect, what happens. So it should, you don't put his words into action and just talk about atom bomb. They are like atom bombs, but they should be put into action. And that's why this atom bomb, today I never wanted to tell you. Because, you know, the situation of the world is quite different. And in this situation, nobody knows what to do and what not to do. And the time will come, everyone will just think about it, what should I do now? What should I do? And of course, there will be no water to drink, no grain to eat. People will eat this grass or dry leaves. That time is going to come, but at that time, the whole world will think about God. Think about God, God now. Nowadays, of course, only few, they think about God. Others, oh, we are enjoying. We are happy. Why should we think about God? When we have some type of suffering, some difficulty, then we'll see. Now, but for the present time, we are enjoying. This is the thing, this is the attitude. And that's why the time is coming. It will take time. But the time will come, the whole attitude of the people will be changed. Awakening means not this awakening. Awakening means nothing, no selfishness, no greed. No greed, no corruption. All I see is corruption all over the world. All over the world to any extent. Every nation, of course, differs. But corruption is there. Lot of corruption, and they think that, oh, I know this, I know that. And they think there is one word in India, Chalta Purja. If you deceive anyone and he should not know that you have deceived, so you think yourself Chalta Purja. Means is very, very smart, intelligent. But this intelligence and smartness, what value? What will you earn? Is there anyone who just lives eternally with body, same body? No. Everyone dies and everyone takes birth. But we don't know that. Now, whatever we do, the deeds, the sanskaras which we collect by doing that, they remain there. So, next birth, of course, you will suffer. You will suffer. And at that time, I had given that example that one day we were in Guru Prasad. All of a sudden, Baba said, let us go to Bandh Garden. Bandh Garden, and we went, our car stopped there, and one beggar comes, blind beggar. And he says, give me one penny, and God would give you more. And Baba looked at him, asked Pendu to give him 5 rupees. So 5 rupees he gave, and he says, God would give you more, and he left. He left, and then Baba was looking at him, and then what happens? That Baba says to us, do you know who is he? He was a king. He was a king, but not a good king. He would not take care of the people. Nothing, his own enjoyment, and they were suffering and suffering and suffering, and taxes would be collected and collected. Same one, of course, he is now blind beggar, and he asked for one penny. So this happens, this is because of our deeds. One day, what happened? We were going from Pune to Satara in the car, and there was one cemetery on the way. Phatia, you know? Phatia? Phatia? The word, the prayer? Huh? Yes? So what happens? That in every anniversary of that person, in 1 year, so people just go and they read Phatia, means prayer for him, for his salvation. So Baba was going, and in the car, And Baba laughed. And we could not believe why he was laughing. Baba says that you know that person, just look at him. It is his own tomb. And he does not know. And he is just doing this fatiha there. Prayer there. We don't know what happens afterwards. We just think that this is the life. Life, to lead life for God. Never forget God. So, and then when you are following the truth, nothing will happen to you. Nothing will happen. No fear for anything. But never forget. I see that gradually now everyone is realizing those who have come in contact, except our infinite grace. He just follows 5%. 5%, 95% he does not, but now he has given promise. So 100% he would follow. Right?
You're absolutely right.
I am very happy. So this is, we just think that people, of course, you are not a priest, you are not anything, you are not respected. Why? What you will gain if you become a priest, or if you become anyone, just some master, or someone who are worshipped? So what will you gain? What will you gain? Yes, you are right, 100%. So never deceive anyone. Never be fearless. Only thing, remember him. Remember him, and that remembrance, it is itself atom bomb. And you are using atom bomb when you remember. Words of truth, there are many, but when those words of truth are in your action, so you stop talking about that. You don't talk about that because they are in action. You know that. So, new life, it is the life of action, which has Baba has given. He did not say that you leave everything. What you have to renounce? Renounce your own false self. So for that purpose, whether you have to go to forest or anywhere and meditate, what will happen? There was one person, King Janak. He was in Himalaya, Nepal, and he was king. So once it so happened that one seeker, he was sitting under a tree, and one old man came and he also sat under the tree. So old man asked him that, where do you live? He says, I am a seeker, so I have no place to live in. And I don't need any place. I just go out from one place to another. Of course, I never live in the village or in any place. I just live under the tree. Oh, very good. Since when you are doing this? He says, since last 12 years. I am a seeker. He said, very good. But what did you get? He said, up till now I did not get, but I will get. I will get because I am doing all this. Begging for food, living under the tree, walking the distance. I don't stay in one place. So that, he says, but everything you told me, it is all right. But something you must have got. No, at present, of course, I did not have anything, no experience. Do you want to God? Do you want God? He said, yes, of course, for God I am doing all this. So if you want God, then of course I will ask you, I will request you to go to not King Janak, but to meet Janak. He is the one who can give God. So go to him. So he said, yes, I will go. Give me the address. He gave the address. And now he goes there. He goes there, Nepal, walking. And he says, where is Janak? He asked the people, Janak? How do you address? Janak, do you know who is Janak? He's the king. And you say Janak? Never say so. It is not good. He is the king. So he says, all right. Then, of course, he goes, the address he had given, he went there, and there was a big palace. Big palace. And the guards were there at the gate. What do you want? I want to see Janak. Janak? They also got upset. He's king. You should not say Janak. Why do you want to meet? No, I have to see him. He said, first I have to seek his permission. And if he gives permission, we will take you. But you be here. So that guard went to ask the king. And here he thinks, he is the king, big palace. How can he give me God? How can he give me God? Who is the king? And that man comes, God comes, and tells him that yes, king wants to see you. So he goes there. And he goes there and he just saw the throne. Everything big and all sofa chairs and this and that. And Janak says that, sit down. So he sat down. What do you want? He says, I want God. Janak says, I will give you God. But now because you have come from different places walking, so 3 days you take rest. You take rest and then afterwards I will tell you how to find God. I will tell you. So he says, now take him to the guest house. And when he goes to the guest house, he says, now what to do? Here of course that all amenities and this and that, I'm not used to it. And he enjoys life. And how can I accept now? I must get out from here. But how to go? In every gate there are the guards, so many guards. What to do now? So then of course his food came. Different dishes. He never thought about that. He never ate in his life. And different dishes. He says, now how can I get God here? How can he give God who is enjoying life like this? But he did eat. He did eat. And his bed. Very comfortable bed. But he was thinking that I want God. And why I am just caught up here? How to just go out of this place? How to go? And he was just sleeping like that. And he was looking at the ceiling. And what does he find? The ceiling is coming down and down and down. You see, if I sleep and if the roof just falls on me, I will die. Whole night he could not sleep. He was looking at the ceiling and the roof was coming down and down and down. Whole night he could not sleep. Next day, the king calls him. And king says, did you sleep last night? He said, no, I could not sleep. Why? The food was not good. The food was most delicious. I never ate in my life such a type of food. Then, whether the bed was not comfortable? The bed was most comfortable. Then why did you not sleep? He says that roof, it was coming down and down and down, and I was looking at it and I thought that if I would sleep, then of course any time the roof will fall down and I will die. And that's why, because of the fear, I could not sleep. And the king says, you think that I am enjoying life here. I am a king. But do you know my responsibility? What is my responsibility? The responsibility is to look after all the people. So because of that, just like you saw the roof coming down and down and you could not sleep, so also my responsibility is such that all the time I have to think about it. I also don't sleep. But you know, still there is time. 12 years again, what you were doing, you do it. And then, of course, you come to me. If you don't find God, then come to me, but 12 years again you go. So he goes. And he goes, and what happens? That whatever he was doing, he came to know that it is not. One has to renounce his own self, own false self. And then of course he could not gain anything. After 12 years he comes, and King Janak gives him realization in a second, in a moment. So that is the thing. If you are eating good food or this or that, it does not mean that you are not spiritual. If you have just not attached to it, you can do anything. Don't remain attached with anything. And that attachment is a very bad thing. You remain bound. So eat well, sleep well, don't worry. Baba is there to take care of you. Don't worry. So now Jivan Mukta, time?
You have 30 more minutes.
31? All right, then now this is the opportunity for you to ask questions.
Okay, 15 minutes.
All right.
The original win happened once, or does it happen continuously?
It happened only once. But it remains continuously with everyone. Till you get God realization, it remains there with you all the time. But what happens that it is with you, but if you do something which are not in response to the whim, so that and that thing you do, then it creates obstruction for the whim to proceed further. But it is always there, continuously till, who am I? You get the reply, I am God. It is there. In every individual, just like God is indivisible, so you are also indivisible. But why this manyness comes? Because the mind. Mind must go. Then you will say that I am indivisible one. And no one is there besides me.
Jai Baba, since we may not see you in an assembly like this again, I hope we do, I have a question on your awakenings. In the awakenings you wrote that beloved Baba, the day he passed away, the day before he passed away, he told you three times that I'm not this body, and he actually pronounced the word remember. Was it the only word he pronounced, yadka or?
Yadrak.
Was that the only word that he pronounced?
Yes.
The rest of it he gestured.
Gestures. And gestures in the beginning, first question, remember this. He did not say, through tongue, he says, remember this, I am not this body. This is the gesture. So he made the gesture and I could understand. But second time, he instead of remember this, he says, yad rakh, means remember this, I am not this body. Yad rakh, that was Hindi. And then, of course, at the time, I did not really feel that Baba has broken his silence. And that's why I did not say anything to anyone. I kept quiet. But that day, I told the incident when I was in hospital, what happened. So then I could realize why Baba said this, that Osho Rajneesh was telling his disciples that after 7 years the vocal cord does not work, and this is the reason Meher Baba gave promises so many times that he is going to speak. He would also fix the date for that, but he could not speak.
I know it's, I've heard about how you were previously living with Baba in the 20s and then you died, and I was wondering if Baba, or if you know exactly who you were, or if Baba ever told you exactly who you were back when you were living with Baba in the 20s.
When I went joined Baba, so I joined him in Dehradun. Dehradun, so Baba asked me, what is your birth date? And I said to him, 13th January 1926. And he asked the Mandli, just before that, who died in the Mandli? So they said that Charles was the Anglo-Indian who was with Baba, and the another one, of course, another one who was there? No. Nervous. So Baba heard and Baba kept quiet. Baba did not say further. But he did say, who died, who was with me. So they said, in that year, of course, asthma, nervous, and another one is Charles. So Baba did not say further, but he heard.
Bao, given the state of the world today, if we feel compelled to do something socially or politically, should we do something, or is that just living in the grip of ignorance?
Just loudly.
Loud.
Given the state of the world today, if we feel compelled to do something politically or socially, should we, or is that just living in the grip of ignorance?
No, whatever you do, socially you do, and because of his love, so it is all right, but outwardly you just make a show of it, so it is no good. Just in his love, of course, we come, sit together, eat. This is spirituality, is not that you should not enjoy. It is not that. If you have the occasion, of course you must. Why not to enjoy? Don't worry, be happy. You just think that Baba has said, don't worry, be happy. Of course I am enjoying. In his name, he is giving me the occasion. And that's why I am enjoying. Do not think that it is a binding. That's why I give this story about King Janak, that he was the king enjoying everything but not attached to anything. He was the master. Now you just see the masters, five perfect masters. Sai Baba, he would live, he would sit under a tree and just smoke pipe. Under the tree sitting there, Narayan Maharaj, he was living like a king, perfect master, living like a king. Then of course there was Upasani Maharaj, of course, whatever you see in his ashram, that was constructed by Baba, God, the construction done there. It was not Upasani Maharaj. And he would just put on the gunny sack and nothing else, whether it is summer or it is winter or it is rainy season, just one gunny sack. So different masters have different work according to the divine plan, and they do it, but everything is spiritual. If you have good food, so why should you not eat? You must eat. What is wrong in that? Think that, yes, of course, he has given me this, I am eating. So that is the thing, the rules and regulations, when the natural life goes away and you think that you are something else. I am just following this, I am following that. What you are following, rules and regulations, who has made rules and regulations? Priest class, television, the channel where the minister would give talk, and so many people and long talk. Sometimes, of course, he would just give little water to everyone, just see what happens to you. Little water. So little water, of course, everyone would go to take that water. Oh, what an experience. They would get experience. So in India too, it is more and more now. Christians, those who live there, they go to the church, then water they give. Hindus, they give this Ganga Jal. She is right. Ganges water. Oh, they go and they bring Ganges water. And then, of course, if anyone goes, Ganges water for something, he is suffering from sickness or suffering from something, and he give. And oh, yes, how are you? I'm all right now, just see. It happens. 1 minute. All right. 1 minute. Sujay Baba. I'm really very happy to be with you. And every time I say that now this is my last trip. But then again I come. So this year, of course, I have said that if Baba wishes, of course I will come. So and of course, I cannot say yes or no, but if it is his wish, I may come, or if it is his wish, I may die. Two things are there. And when I die, how can I come? I cannot come. I can come in a spirit form. But then how will you know? In spirit form you will know. Yes. Ah, because you are Jivan Mukta, of course. He will know. Kutub-e Alam also.
I think I know how we can detect you.
So Jai Baba, really very happy.